Warning! This video is not meant to offend and harass Nintendo. Look, I like Nintendo games, and they was important on my childhood. But in their consoles, there's been many mistakes that need to be addressed. But this doesn't mean PlayStation is perfect and Nintendo is trash. Hi! I'm Amotube and today I talk about two topics, Nintendo consoles and PS5 wishlist. In this video, I tell you why Nintendo should stop making consoles, and then I will share my wishlist for PS5. First, I have to talk about Nintendo. First, let's talk about the worst problem. The last Nintendo consoles doesn't have enough performance. For example, on Nintendo Switch, there are frame rate drops on Legend of Zelda, Breath of the Wild, and Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Maybe it's just bad optimization, but I think the main problem is the hardware. The second problem is the cartridges. Why Nintendo use cartridges after the Nintendo 3DS? Modern games need a lot of storage, but the storage of cartridges is limited. I think the limited storage of cartridges is the worst intention of Nintendo games. That's why most of Nintendo games are unfinished and have too much limitations. Third problem is the bad ports on third-party games. Most of the third-party games on Nintendo consoles are inferior versions of the original games, especially on Wii U and Switch. And for inferior, I don't mean about graphic. For example, Dark Souls Remastered run on 30fps unlike PS4 and other consoles. And Minecraft Wii U Edition have better frame rate, smaller walls and lower render distance in comparison to PS4 Edition. I hate it. Needless to say, even the lack of good third-party games is a problem. In my opinion, Nintendo games shouldn't be an exclusive of Nintendo consoles. We need Nintendo games on the PC and the PlayStation. And most of Nintendo consoles are pretty bad for some bad features and limitations. The GameCube Tiny Disc have small storage and they suck. The Game Boy screen is too dark and the Game Boy Advance SP doesn't have the iPhone jack. Nintendo Wii is just a overclocked GameCube with more RAM and more storage on disk. The Wii U development was rushed. Wii U have just 32GB of storage on Premium Edition. And the Wii U gamepad cannot go far from the TV. And the Nintendo Switch have just 32GB of storage like Wii U Premium Edition. That's why Nintendo should stop making consoles. And Nintendo should start to make games on other consoles. I hope Nintendo make games on PC and PS5. If you want an in-depth analysis of Nintendo consoles, I will do a video about it in the future. PS5 is not a bad console, but it should have some features. First, me like the Nintendo consoles. I hope me will have more customization, like more hairstyles, more skin colors, maybe a color wheel, and more build options. Ray tracing options for games. I think ray tracing could have a bigger impact on frame rate, and I want the option to disable it. Because I like high frame rate. Maybe more than one option could be implemented, but I don't know. Graphic settings on 30fps games. For example, normal setting is for 30fps, performance setting is for 60fps, and ultra performance setting is for over 60fps. These settings are essential. Some free online services, like Nintendo Switch. In my opinion, some online features should be free. For example, PlayStation Store, DLCs and updates, shared content mod for games, like Smash Ultimate, system updates, local multiplayer and friends code, and things like YouTube and Netflix. Even a low price for PlayStation Network is important. Maybe it could have the same price of Nintendo Switch Online. Cross-platform gaming on games like Fortnite. Seriously, why Sony didn't let Epic Games to put cross-platform gaming between PS4 and Xbox One in Fortnite? Why? Easy to program games because modern games require more time of programmation to be good. It would be a great help for developers if the game engines are easier to use and if the video games are easier to program. I say this because I don't want to wait 2030 for Kingdom Hearts 4. 60fps for PS4 games. I don't know exactly the PS5 specs, but I think PS5 will be very powerful in comparison to PS4 Pro. I hope PS5 will be compatible with PS4 games and run Days Gone and Death Stranding on 60fps. No more consoles-breaking games like Anthem, seriously. I hope the next video games will not commit the same mistakes of Anthem. Not too much quality for the graphics. To avoid breaking the console and avoid frame rate drops. Even too many polygons is not good. Not too exaggerated saturation and exaggerated bloom effects for graphics. These things sucks in the graphics. Nintendo games, because, like I said before, Nintendo games should be on PS5 and other consoles. Family filter is needed to prevent 7 years old from playing GTA 5 and emulated games. Adult-only video games. Please, Sony, put adult-only games on PS5. PS5 need them. The last, but the most important, no censorships. No more blood, guns, panties, gore, genitalia, nudity, and sexual censorships. It doesn't matter if the age ratings will be high. It doesn't matter if a kid's game be rated T14. It's ESRB-fault if most of the video games have wrong age rating. And please, no censorships on adult and on M-rated video games. Censorships on games like GTA 5 doesn't have sense. There are reasons if GTA 5 be rated PEGI 18. And if a game being censored, it should be an anti-censorship patch, like Devil May Cry 5. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, subscribe and put a like. But if you want to share your opinions or if you are against this video, tell me in the comments. I see you in the next video. Bye!